we identified 720 miles of shoreline that could potentially be impacted by an oil spill in the Straits.
There is a pipeline that's sitting at the bottom of the Straits of Mackinac. It was designed for a 50-year life, and it's been down there for 63 years. There's a risk involved in this.
A single oil spill would not impact that entire shoreline, but single oil spills could impact up to 150 miles of shoreline. The parameters in this study used three different initial release volumes of oil. So for those three different volumes, we calculated where oil would spread and how big an impact it would have on the shoreline. How often does oil in these scenarios impact Mackinac Island? How often does Mackinac City get oiled? How big is the area of the spill as a function of time?
What this study does is it actually quantifies where a spill could potentially have impacts both in the open waters and on the shorelines.
The place where Lake Michigan and Lake Huron are connected is different than either Lake Michigan or Lake Huron. Very small difference in water level between the two lakes can cause huge currents in the Straits of Mackinac.
Think about what's at risk there. Think about the recreational tourism economy. Think about the drinking water intakes, the marinas that are up there, the state parks and beaches.
My expertise is not in plans of action. It's really in doing the best job we can to simulate what would happen after a spill. And I feel that's my responsibility as a scientist.